In all affairs of life, there must be standards of authority, otherwise chaos would overtake the earth. In business, government, recreation, or what have you, someone has to make the rules for us to follow. If not, everyone would be his own authority and society would fragment and crumble away. Well, the same is true in religion. There must be authority. However, there are several authorities being followed by people today in their worship of God. Let's examine a few of these and then take a look at what the true source of authority is. We see some accepting the religion of their parents as their standard of serving God. Many pride themselves on the fact that they are from a long line of ancestors who are practitioners of a particular faith. But is this a safe source of authority? Well, of course, the answer is no. History teaches us that this can be quite disastrous. Ancient Israel changed religion many times, often with the passage of just one generation, as they shifted back and forth between the worship of the true God and the false gods of the nation around them. This was what brought God's displeasure down upon their heads and resulted in their being carried away into captivity by their enemies. The Apostle Paul had to give up his father's religion when he learned the truth about Christ. He said in Philippians 3:7, "But what things were gained to me? Those I counted loss for Christ." But why did he give up his former worship? Well, it was because he found that there was no salvation from and hope of heaven in his father's religion. So then, using our ancestors' faith as our standard is not a safe guide. Others will use their own conscience as their guide. Well, is this safe? Well, if so, then we have as many standards as we have people. Now, most religious people are conscientious, but a great many of them are disagreed. The Apostle Paul was a conscientious man before he obeyed Christ, but he was a lost man at the time. The conscience is good, but it is safe only when it is based upon the truth of God. A conscience does not set the standard, it only approves or disapproves of conduct based upon a given standard. If the standard is not a true one, then the conscience can be perfectly clean, but dead wrong. He may not be offending against his standard, but if the standard itself is faulty, then the clean conscience does not make the man right in the sight of God. Well, still others think that the safest course is to simply follow the majority. Well, the trouble with this is that the majority often does evil. It was the majority that screamed for the blood of innocent Jesus, even though they did it ignorantly. Also, Jesus said that the majority are walking in the broad path that leads to destruction, and that few will be saved, Matthew 7:13-14. Obviously, to follow the majority in religion is to be found in the wrong way. Well, some religious groups think that the safe course is to follow church councils and let the delegates decide what is a good way to approach God. Well, the problem here is that church councils often contradict one another, and this is because different parties within the councils sometimes disagree. Well, surely, our salvation should not hang on how one's vote goes. As time passes, succeeding councils sometimes feel that the creeds need to be revised. Well, what is believed this year may be discarded next year. Well, does that make sense to dangle the destiny of our souls upon such a skinny thread? Well, of course not. So what is the standard of authority? Friends, the Bible is the standard of authority. The Apostle Peter said that the gospel is the word of the Lord and that it endureth forever, 1 Peter 1:25. The scriptures of the New Testament contain the words of Christ, which Christ said are the truth that will make us free, John 8:31-32. And this word of God will give us an eternal inheritance, Acts 20:32. And it is the engrafted word which is able to save our souls, James 1:21, and that the scriptures can make us wise unto salvation and furnish us unto every good work, 2 Timothy 3:15-17. Friends, what we find is that the Bible is the only religious authority. that we can count on. We need to place our trust in it and follow it alone. Friends, we thank you for joining us for our program today, and we pray that God blesses you with a wonderful day.